hashish.
Matt.
His journalist Hazem Sadi describes it as a world of criminal machismo.
The ideology of tribalism is very much based on manhood.
Stay.
And being able to challenge the state, being able to cross the borders illegally, being able to get your bread and butter through force.
Politicians and commentators have blasted the kidnappings as anarchy. Samir Jaja, head of the Lebanese Forces, a right-wing Christian party, called for a state of emergency. It's as if Lebanon has no semblance of being a country. No constitution nor rule of law, armed groups running around doing what they please. They draft their own foreign policy, speak on behalf of the country, and kidnap whoever they want. On August 9th, the Lebanese government announced the arrest of a former information minister, Michel Salaha. It also charged Syrian security chief Ali Mamlouk with giving Salaha explosives. Their alleged aim was to assassinate top religious leaders in order to set off a war among rival sects. The Lebanese state is weak in part by design, with religious sects and their political parties sharing power within the government. But challenging the Syrian regime by arresting Samaha was a bold move on the government's part, says the University of Beirut political scientist Hilal Kasham.
Samaha is not an ordinary person, you know. I am absolutely sure that had the government
had
damning evidence,
they
wouldn't have
Darwin.
Analysts say chaos in Lebanon could benefit the Syrian regime in several ways. President Bashar al-Assad could divert attention from the civil war battering his regime. He could blame the chaos on al-Qaeda, which Western governments fear may be aiding Syrian rebels. But, Kasham explains, each Lebanese faction has foreign patrons, all of whom are now preoccupied with Syria. This is especially true of Iran, whose proxy is the Shiite militant group Hezbollah, whose military wing is stronger than the Lebanese army.
You have to not create Hezbollah in order to exhaust and
exhaust
its resources in the areas of Beirut. They created it not for the rescue should a regional war break out.
What?
Therefore, engaging Hezbollah in a civil war in Lebanon defeats the idea behind
what?
Its creation.
Lebanon's sectarian and political divisions are unquestionably deep, says Kasham. But for now, the consensus seems to be that nobody wants a repeat of the country's devastating 1975 to 1990 civil war. Anthony Kim, NPR News.
When Ethiopia's prime minister died this week, the country lost a longtime leader. The United States lost a longtime ally in its fight against East African extremists, and human rights campaigners lost an opponent. Melis Zenawi is a major player in the region, and we're going to talk about his legacy with NPR's Ophelia Quist-Darkton. She's on the line from her base in Dakar. Hi, Ophelia.
Greetings.
There must be many Ethiopians who can remember no other leader, given that this man is in charge since the early 1990s.
Indeed, the young Ethiopians only know Melis Zenawi as their prime minister. Of course, all the Ethiopians know the former emperor Haile Selassie, and then the bad man of Ethiopia, Mengistu Haile Mariam, who was the communist hardline leader that Melis Zenawi and his